If you need to attach a wire to a stud like you'd find in an inverter, on a battery, or on a bus bar, you'll need to crimp a wire lug onto the wire. And that's exactly what we're going to cover here in lesson number 5 of this wire terminals playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, I've already talked about how to cut wires, how to strip wires, and how to use heat shrink back in lessons 4.2 through 4.4 of this academy. So in this video, I'm just going to assume you already know how to do all of that and only talk about crimping. Let's get started. How to crimp wire lugs. Once you have the correct lug size for the wire size, as well as the stud size for the equipment, we need a crimper. And personally, I like this particular one from Temco. Been using it for several years, and I'll link to it in the video description. This crimper is adjustable for different wire sizes, as small as 10 gauge all the way up to 4-aught, and actually some bigger sizes, by simply turning the knob on top and lining the selector line up with the appropriate wire size. And this crimper simply works by punching an indent into the lug every single time the handles are squeezed. So once the crimper is adjusted to the proper wire size, I'm going to put my wire lug into the crimper with the back of the lug on the indention spike, just like so. And then I'll let the handle kind of fall under its own gravity just to hold the lug in place. Then I'll put the stripped wire into the lug like so, making sure to get all strands of copper into the terminal itself. And then I'll firmly squeeze the wire into the terminal like so, and press the handles of the crimpers together like that. And I kind of felt like that was maybe a little too easy, so I can sort of lift up on the handle like so, give that another half a turn, and then give it one more push, and then that felt pretty solid. And here's what we are left with. We have this indention right here, and we actually have a little bit of room to go ahead and crimp it twice, which I sometimes like to do if there's enough room. So put it back into the crimper and position it to where it gets a second crimp. Squeeze the handles together, let loose, and now we have two indention spikes here on the back, and this whole barrel is kind of formed into a nice triangle shape. And as a fun side quest, here is a lug that I cut in half so that you can actually see how the fine strands of the wire are pushed together so hard that they effectively become one block of solid copper inside of the lug. Once the wire lug is crimped onto the wire, we're just going to give the lug a really good pull to make sure that it doesn't come loose. And here is a table with values for how much force you should be able to apply to the lug before it comes loose, and it's truly a lot. Most of us won't actually have the means to sort of like measure this, so just do your best, really give it a good pull, and make a really good judgment call here. Now, the process for crimping all wire lugs from 10 gauge all the way up to 4-aught is just the same as I just showed. You just need to, you know, dial the crimper in to match the wire size. And then after crimping and doing your pull test, you'll want to put on some heat shrink onto the terminal, like we talked about in the previous lesson of this academy. Wire lug crimping tips. Now that you've got a high quality wire lug terminal that will last for years to come, here's some additional helpful tips. Make sure your wire lug is twisted to the proper direction before crimping. Once it's crimped, a wire might sort of be hard to twist so the lug faces the right direction to attach it to the component, and this is most critical with short wires. And consider clamping your crimper to your work table. When you're putting pressure on this handle trying to crimp the lug into place, if it's not clamped down, it's easy to let the crimper fall over and it will really smash your fingers. Ask me how I know. Alternative crimpers. Now, there are several different types of crimpers on the market, and I'll give a few words about a few of them. Now, I've personally had pretty bad luck with the sub-$100 yellow hydraulic crimpers with dies. I have used them for our first van conversion back in 2017. And then whenever I redid the electrical system in 2021 to update it to Victron equipment, I found that over half of the wire lugs were loose after those 5 years on the road, because with that crimper, you're sort of at the mercy of the size of the die, and you can't get it any tighter if you need to, like you can with this adjustable one. You know, I know many people like those hydraulic crimpers, but I don't. Do with that information what you will. Hammer crimpers also give inconsistent results. And with the way that I've seen some of y'all swing a hammer, I just can't trust any of you to get consistent crimps that meet the ratings from the table I shared earlier. Now, there are also some more expensive crimpers on the market, but I sort of don't feel like they do any better of a job than this one does, except for maybe like a battery-powered crimper where we could crimp wire in a tight space, which is an area where this one sort of falls short, but at a pretty significant cost difference. Now, we're going to be putting wire lugs onto a lot of wires throughout the rest of this academy, so be sure to bookmark this lesson for future reference and come back to it if you need a refresher, because going forward, I'm just going to assume that you now know how to crimp a wire lug. Up next, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about crimping ring terminals onto wire, so click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there.